This movie is more or less exactly what it says it is, and you can't be mad at it for that. So, Two Night Stand is this new romance funny type of movie that came out this weekend, and you have this lady named Megan, played by Analeigh Tipton, who's down on her luck, doesn't have a job, and lives with her roommates. Well, actually, the movie starts with her and the guy, Alec, played by Miles Teller, in bed after the one-nighter, and she tries to get away, but the alarm goes off. Then it goes back to the flashback, or before that, or whatever. So anyway, Megan's basically this chick with not a lot to offer. She sits in a room and resorts to online dating to try and hook up with somebody. And then she gets with Alec, and the next thing you know, they end up having the proverbial one-night stand. Then the movie flashes back, or forward. I think it's back. Well, technically it's forward. Anyway, it flashes forward to Megan trying to sneak off, but Alec wakes up, cuts the alarm off, goes back to sleep, and then that's basically much it. Then he asks a question once they wake up, which irks her, and then they get into this really funny, interesting fight, and then dislike each other after that, and she tries to leave again, but this time they end up being snowed in his apartment. I thought to myself, okay, that's gotta suck. That is going to be so awkward for them both. And it was, because they end up trying to talk and break the silence and get over all the bullshit from earlier. And for a while, that's pretty much all that happens. There's some humor here and there, but for the most part, they just talked and interacted and tried to ease the tension, which didn't really excite me all that much. I was just waiting for something to happen because it dragged on and on for a while, doing random activities. And then before you know it, they end up doing the only thing you imagine doing when you're still in your apartment with one other person of the opposite sex. And then I was like, okay, now this is interesting, obviously. How they get to that point, however, made me smile a bit. And after that ends, the mood suddenly shifts because something happens. Obviously, I'm not going to tell you what it is, but when it happens, you're like, oh, that was unexpected. And now everything's like, okay, now what? Where do you go from here? Well, from here, once this thing happens, you already kind of know how the movie's going to end if you've seen movies like this before and you're just wondering how they get to that ending. But the way everything plays out is, like, really, of all possible routes to anything, that's the one you took? Why'd you do that? Why that? In any case, the movie ends well, and it's pretty much what you expect. So, as far as the movie goes, it's actually a pretty decent, funny romance film. Drags on for some time, then gets interesting in the last two halves, but kind of predictable all the same. However, it did entertain me, and any movie that does that gets points, and this one gets a silver ribbon from me, because humor and entertainment are key. The acting's not bad either, for what it's worth. So, Two Night Stand, have you seen it? Again, like with my Reclaim review, you might not have because it wasn't a heavily promoted film, but if you have, what'd you think? Did you like it, dislike it, find it funny or not? However you feel about it, leave a comment, and while you're at it, why not subscribe and see what else I have in store for later.